In the previous lecture, we had solved this problem of ball plate impact, and we can see the solution has been completed successfully. Now we are going to view the results. Now to view the results, first of all, I will cancel this window. I will go to File and I will go to Open. Here we need to open up this file, LSDyna binary plot. Click on this. Go to the folder where the file has been saved, and we see one option that is called D3 plot. Click on this D3 plot. We don't need to open this file 01 and 02. We need to open the original file D3 plot. Click on open. So in the D3 plot file, all the results are stored. So now let's rotate this file and then click on this forward option. Click on forward and you can see how the ball is going to impact on the plate. So here we can see stat, and inside the stats we can see the maximum number of stats are 11. Since we had defined the 10 number of interval between 0 to 1, and it is going to take extra 1 for the 0 time. So that is why it has 11 stats, and that is the advantage of selecting the time interval or DT value. Now let's say I want to view the results. To view the result, we need to go to this option of post. Click on this post. Click on this first option, fringe component. Now inside this fringe component, first I want to calculate the stresses. And in case of impact problem, we need to find out the stress that is called von Mises stress. Click on this and click on done. Now we can see how the von Mises stress is changing. And we want to find out von Mises stress for the last stage. See, click on this stop. Now let's go to each state one by one. First, go to state number 1. Here it is showing state number 1. Then click on this next state. Now this ball is coming near to this plate. Then state number 3, the ball is impacting. State number 4, 5, 6, 7. Now at the 7th stat, we can see the ball is reversing back. At the 8th, we can see it is bouncing back once again. Like this. So for each stat, we need to find out the maximum stress. And we can see maximum stress will be like this. So this is the value of maximum stress, 3.62 e to the power 8. And this is in the units of, so we can change this to mm, and you can find out the exact stress here. Now let's say I want to find out the displacement. So I will once again go to fringe component, click on NDV, nodal displacement velocity. Here we can specify velocity in any direction. Here I will select result displacement. Click on done. And then we can forward this. You can see how the displacement is changing here. So the maximum displacement will be in 11th state. So at the state number 7, it is 3.4. After that step, the ball is going to bounce back. We can also pick this handle to increase or decrease the speed of animation. So when I increase this, the animation is going to speed up. And when I make a check on this, it is going to continue show the animation. After that, since we had defined the SKI parameter in the database, we can also find out the energies. To find out the energies of the system, go to this history card. Here we had defined the GL state, so that is global state. So click on global, hold down the control key and select kinetic energy and internal energy, and then click on plot. Now inside this plot we can see this red color is showing the kinetic energy of the system. So initially the kinetic energy is maximum, and after that when it is going to impact like this, the kinetic energy is going to decrease. But after this time the ball is going to bounce back. It means once again the kinetic energy will increase slightly and then it will decrease. And here this is the internal energy. So initially the internal energy will decrease, and due to this collision the internal energy is going to increase, and when the ball will bounce back it is going to decrease and then it is constant. You can go to this attributes and you can check. See, when I click on this internal energy it is going to show in this green color. It means this green is internal energy. Similarly, when I click on this kinetic energy it is showing red color. So here you can change all the properties like thickness of this line, etc., line style. I click on quit, click on done. Another way of viewing the result is we can go to this velocity option. Go to velocity vector. Here we need to select velocity, click on dynamic and click on apply. Okay, now let's view the animation. So decrease the speed, start the animation. See, initially we can see these arrows are highlighting. This is the step number one. So now we can see the arrows are going downward. After that, step number 2, 3. Now when the ball is going near to the plate and it is impacting, again step number 4, 5, 6. So in this way we can view the result like this. I click on done. So in this way we can view the result in LS Dyna.